This beautiful creature looks a lot like a cat you might find on someone's porch or in their living room. In fact, it is the ancestor of today's house cat. As you can see, the modern cat has not diverged much from its ancestral appearance. They now come in more colors, and they have different coat lengths, and some breeders are now selectively breeding for strange features such as hairlessness or congenital dwarfism. But many cats still bear the mackerel, buff brown, tabby pattern, short hair, and body type of their forebears, such as Osmosis here, who has very generously volunteered to show off her beautiful fur for this video. If you see those thin stripes in her coat, that is the mackerel tabby pattern, since those stripes are thin, sort of like fish bones. Today's cats also retain many of their wild instincts to hunt, sharpen their claws, roam, and defend territory. Cats were finely tuned over millennia to be expert and adaptable predators. These instincts often cause issues when cats are kept indoors with too little stimulation. Cats who are bored may become excessively destructive, needy, or obese. We must always remember that our animals were designed to perform at a very high level, both physically and mentally, so if our animals are too sedentary, serious issues can arise. Dogs are also descended from a fierce predator. Smart, loyal, affectionate, and social, wolf society resembles our own in many ways. Perhaps this is why they are the first animal to have been domesticated. Unlike cats, dogs have diverged from their ancestors in appearance quite dramatically. Think of a dachshund or a beagle. They look like they could each be their own separate species, distinct from both each other and the wolf. However, dogs are still considered a subspecies of the wolf, and each breed of dog is still considered to be the same species in subspecies as any other dog. Their wide variation in appearance is a result of several factors. Wolves, and therefore dogs, seem to have exceptional diversity and plasticity in their genome. They have also been bred for specific traits much longer than any other domesticated animal. Dogs have been incredibly beneficial to people. They can, and have, perform an extremely wide variety of jobs, from hunting, to herding, to protection, to warming laps. They have pulled carts, entertained children, been used for sacrifice and consumption. Even among dogs who hunt, there are dogs who specifically hunt hares, dogs who hunt foxes, deer, and even bear. Dogs have only recently been bred purely as pets. Until now, they had jobs. They were fierce warriors, avid hunters, loyal guardians. Many of those instincts are still quite strong in the dog of today, and the desire to roam many miles a day, protect territory, hunt, and be with their pack are still there. These desires to fulfill instinctive behaviors often do not translate into modern life very well. Dogs are expected to spend vast amounts of time in isolation, doing nothing but sleep while their family is away for the day. This can lead to some of the behavior issues we see in dogs. We must remember our animals evolved to be highly functional, highly active creatures in a very stimulating, complex environment. While their physical needs may be met, many instinctive needs are left unfulfilled. Understanding the wild history of our companions can lend us insight into what they need to lead fulfilling lives today. You guys are going to watch a video on dog domestication, and then we will get back together for our final discussion.